Hey tech lovers, welcome back to another exciting episode of Mobile Funda. Today we are going to talk about HyperOS 3.0 latest system launcher and a brand new control center that will take your experience to the next level. So if you are a Note 13 Pro 5G user, then definitely watch this video till the end. Rest, every Xiaomi user can enjoy this brand new control center. So let's start today's video without wasting any more time. By the way, if you found this video helpful, then like this video and subscribe to the channel so that you keep getting such informative videos in the future as well. Friends, now let's come to today's video, where first of all we will talk about the system launcher, whose version we will see 1135 and in the end 1745. And I am using it on my Note 13 Pro 5G since yesterday, and the experience was really good, and it running like a butter on my Note 13 Pro 5G. Apart from this, there is also a new feature. As soon as we go to its setting, there is a new option of double tap on empty space. If you turn it on, then when you double tap on any empty space on the home screen, then your phone will turn off. So now you will not need to press the power button again and again. However, if we select the 4x6 layout of this launcher, then the alignment of widgets and icons doesn't match on Note 13 Pro 5G, which you can see on the screen as well. And this issue was also there in HyperOS 1.0, if you remember. Since I am using this launcher on an Android 15 device, so maybe that's also one of the reasons. Anyway, if you want to try this out, you will find the latest HyperOS 3.0 launcher APK in the pinned comment below. But remember to take a backup of your current launcher. Otherwise, you will have to arrange the apps on the home screen again. Now moving on to the brand new HyperOS Control Center, which is based on HyperOS 3.0. Here you will see the control center in this layout, where the top toggles appear in rounded rectangle and square shapes, while the bottom ones are fully rounded. The most interesting thing I found in this control center is its icons. They look quite unique, and when you turn them on, the icons change like this, which enhance the look of this control center even more. But there is also one drawback. There are no animations, which I found quite disappointing. Now the notification panel comes in a simple layout, which looks almost like the stock theme. Next is the status bar, which also looks a bit unique here. On the left side you get day and date, while the remaining icons are placed on the right side. In addition, the music shortcut, brightness tab, and volume control layout appear with a white background along with red and blue icons, which again enhance the overall look. But one thing to note, this control center only applies in dark mode, since right now it doesn't work on light mode. Hopefully, we will get to see that too in a future update. Now to apply this control center, you will need to apply this theme, Monica, either as status bar or as system. And you will find the link for it in the pinned comment below. So that's it for today's video. I hope your today's funda was clear. If yes, then like this video and share your thoughts in the comment below. See you in the next video with another interesting topic. Till then, keep exploring and keep customizing. Jai Hind.